the crippled wing, pulled against the crimson sky. At sunset near the covered bridge, one evening in July, I leaned against a fallen log and watched him in the failing light. He beat the blood-red sky and won a moment in free flight. And as he did his lonely dance across the twilight's darkened stage, an audience of wind-blown weeds applauded his ballet. And crouched amid the willow wands, I held my breath and closed my eyes, and opening them again, looked down through dust's fast fading sky. I had become a crippled bird and felt the wind tear at my wing. I chased the evening shadows down past twilight's glimmering, and stretched beneath my broken wing the works of men, mere children's toys. I pierced the marshland mists and knew a pain transcending joy. Then suddenly I was myself, alone in blackness dark and deep, and nothing of the bird remained but memories to keep. Many men have sought the sky on wings of prayer and poetry. Some transcend this mortal sphere and glimpse eternity. Oh, I have tasted mystic wine and heard the north wind caressing, then lifted out of space and time upon a crippled wing. Then lifted out of space and time upon